Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Do carefully sit down. I can see it's going to be well over the morning. Listen, guys, there's only one boss in this place. Nobody tells me what to do.
Natalie Bardsley, dressage world champion, professional model and part-time student of The Grange, Cheshire's leading independent school. I live the Cheshire life of snobbery, poshos and gossip. The Grange School is home of elite sport, elite academia and elite people, where the truth is more interesting than the fiction. Follow me as I go in to tell you about the lives of Cheshire's finest people. Introduce you to my teachers.
The staff room is full of protons, neutrons, electrons, and morons.
Mr. Mac may be the head of graphics, but we all know I'm the real Queen Bee.
I can talk to you all day about cells, brain cells. It's a shame my husband doesn't have any.
I might teach business, but the only business I'm interested in is other people's.
I may be small, but my opinions are big.
I may be an English teacher, but the only language I speak is the truth.
In a department full of actors, it's hard not to be fake.
It's all about supply and demand, and there's always demand for me.
I think it might be time to show you the worst of all. The mean of the mean. The plastics.
That one there, that's Alice Gerard. She's one of the dumbest girls you'll ever meet. Kirsty sat next to her in chemistry last year.
She asked me how to spell H2O.
And that little one, that's Katie Binns.
She seems nice and all, but look at her face. She'd stop traffic with that.
Katie Binns knows everybody's business. She knows everything about everyone.
That's why her hair is so big. It's full of secrets.
And evil takes a human form in George Hull. Don't be fooled, because he may seem like your typical selfish, backstabbing, tart-faced trash bag, but in reality, he is so much more than that.
He's the queen bee, the star. Those other two are just his little workers.
George Hull. How do I even begin to explain George Hull?
George Hull is flawless. I saw George Hull wear army pants and flip-flops, so I wore army pants and flip-flops.
Rumour has it his bum is insured for £10,000.
I heard you win a gold medal in the Olympics, in Taekwondo.
George Hull, I taught him once, it was a dream come true.
I hear he has daily coffee with Mrs. Lennon, and they talk about how pretty he is.
I hear he changed his hair colour to work on his modelling career.
I heard he can do a handstand and go straight into the splits.
He once punched me in the face. It was awesome.
He always looks fierce. He always wins Rear of the Year.
Who cares?
I care.
Anyway, we have warned you. Maybe keep your distance.
If you're a real raver. Whoa. One finger's if you're a real raver.
A freak like me just needs infinity.
Watching first gear.
Yeah, I am.
Through the night, make it so much love. Dead sleep when the sun comes up.
What are you saying, you little twerp?
Oh,
then titty.
Make your wish.
I wish I was big.
Thank you.
And now it's time for me. That says grade 7 musician. I'm actually grade 8, so Kirsty, we're having a talk later. I have been playing the trombone for eight years now, and it's my favourite instrument. I really like, I really love bones. today I'm going to be playing my favourite piece by my favourite composer. It's called Ride of the Valkyries, and it's by Richard Wagner. Thank you. Excuse me?
You, sir.
Have you got a problem?
Thank you.
Do you want to settle this? Like men.
There's only one way we can settle this, obviously. So, where's Tom Collins?
I'm about to evoke. They say from the evoke to reach you the vote. You die as a sapling, not even a GMO. I can't stop, I'm Muhammad Ali. Float like a butterfly.
by sitting like a bee, you're wider than snow, but you have to agree. Let's pull up, take it slow now. Something easier for you. See what you have to say. You look soft, just like blue.
Oh, you can rap fast, that's true. But I've got something else to say. This is a public embarrassment, your middle name. Well, when I'm not saying that you won't ever be the same. Your arms are your bars are poo. And just like Mr. Shaw, you will be bald at 22. Always staring at a screen, your eyes are going square. At least no other woman ever put that ahead.
If you were a spice, could you flower? Did that hurt? Did it cross the line from banter? Might have been a bit hurt. Mr. Oaks and Hisco Bats, you're just a racist joke. And from what you say about women, you like a sexist flow. I'm done now, you're finished, nothing left to see. So go home, kid, it's over. The winner is me.
You suck.
Floor in America ever recovered?
Another standout was Emma getting run over by a bike at the geography trip to Castleton.
The relationships in our year have also gone from strength to strength, and for that we must applaud them.
We are all delighted to be kept up to date with every single detail of Tom Carl's relationship with Georgia and the infamous Spam and Pineapple account.
Of course, some friendships have blossomed too, especially Amber and Amy's, that has delved so much deeper than we ever thought.
Driving definitely hasn't been our strong suit.
We've had a few people fail their driving tests. Becky Atkin, Will Ballon, Kate Barkley, Will Worthington, Tom Stanning, Jacob and Connor, who drove through a red light, which isn't much worse than Emma, who stopped at green.
After passing our test, we've had our fair share of problems on the road. James hit Mia, Gabby hit Jamie, Will Shaw hit a parent, Will Ballon hit a pheasant, Maddie hit a man, Kirsty hit a tree, Alice hit a tree, Spencer hit a tree, Kate hit a wall, and Connor hit a house. And the list goes on.
However, both of us have had the best time at school, and we know we speak for the rest of the year too. We just want to say a quick thanks to every teacher, every friend, and every other member of staff that has made our time here at school so special and so memorable. I think it's safe to say we're all going to miss this place a lot, but for now, this is the class of 2018, over and out.